Hey folks, so I'm nearly done with this diorama. The figures are done, the vehicles are just about finished. I'm gonna do a little bit of weathering on the R35, but that's about it. And then I just need to do the texturing and the water, which is what I'm gonna do today. Now I have a few methods that I do, or that I use to texture water, depending on what kind of water it is. Rough water, still water, pond water, murky water, you know, swampy, lake, wind swept, you know, there's all kinds of different effects that play on water. So this is not particularly windy or anything, or even like rapidly in motion or anything. It'll have basically it's a canal, so there's gonna have some flow. You're not necessarily going to be able to perceive that flow. Since that was going to be an issue with this, I added the water flowing out of the spout here to give a sense of some motion flow to the scene. So the first thing that I need to do is turn that into more of like what flowing water is. Right now all it is a piece of clear sprue. I just took a piece of this here and heated it and then bent it into an L shape, well, roughly L shape, and then glued it in there with the short end of the out the top, so that the bottom of the thing was touching the surface of the water. And that was it. And I glued it in there with PVA so it dries clear. And then once it dried, I mixed up a little bit of the Woodland Scenics realistic water and flowed it in on either side of the pieces of sprue, because there's like a void, because it's not completely flat and it doesn't fit the concave shape of the pipe completely. So there's like, you know, like a gap on either side. So I filled that with realistic water. That was tinted with a little bit with the same stuff that I tinted this water with. I also used this pipette and squirted Woodland Scenics realistic water through the grates into this thing here. Unfortunately, I screwed up the ratio for the tinting and it came out of the wrong color, as did this. So I don't know if you can see it. It's like it looks like freshly churned muddy water, but that works to my advantage because these are outflows. So, you know, if there's any silt or anything around those areas, it would be churned up from motion. So that's my story. I'm going to stick to it. However, it's a mistake. One thing I've learned how to do through modeling, it's the one skill that I value above all others, and that's how to cover my mistakes, because I make a lot of them. And that was one. The other one was when I poured this, and I mentioned this in my previous video, when I poured this water, I forgot to tint the first pour. So it was poured perfectly clear. And then I went, oh shit, oh well, it needed to be murky. So I tinted the next layer. Unfortunately, that would cause, you know, you have a perfectly clear bottoms part and then a murky, it looks like a parfait. So I knew that was not going to work out, but when you look at it through the surface like this, it's the color that I want. And so that's fine. But however, the transparent effect of being able to see through the sides here was lost. So I've painted it now on the side so you can't see through it anymore. It's all covered up. It's all gone now. So I lost that little nicety to the scene, but oh well. Like I said, one thing I've learned is how to cover up my mistakes. Sometimes I don't always cover them up well. Sometimes my mistakes are so bad there's nothing I can do but just sit there and go, shit. No. Happens all the time. So the water effects, I have this Woodland Scenics water effect stuff, which is basically like clear silicone, but it's thinner than silicone, and it dries clear. It's like a structured gel, so I can use that. And I have This is just Artist Loft coarse texture gel, which is what I use to make foam for rough water and stuff. I'll be using that around the outflow there. And then I have basically the exact same stuff as the water effects, but it's a very expensive version from Germany that I've had for a long time called Crystal Gel. So this is basically the same sort of stuff as the Woodland Scenics. I'll be using this because I'm almost out of it and I want to use it up and, you know, finish it off before I start using the brand new water effects that I got from a friend of mine, Nick. Hi, Nick. How you doing? Yeah, so that's what we're going to do. So the first thing I'm going to do is add the surface texture, like the waves. Now, it's not like a, you know, rough ocean or anything like that. It's just, it's very rare that water is like flat calm, you know. I mean, it happens, obviously, but it's not very good if you're trying to show interest in a model. So a flat calm on water, you know, is not very interesting unless it's like a bog. Or it's an effect you're expecting. You're not really expecting it for this, so I'm not going to do that. So basically what I do is take a little measuring cup, just a little thing like that, and I squirt a little bit of this gel. You can actually see what it looks like when it dries on there. The white balance would fuck off. It's just nice and clear. That's what it looks like when it dries. So like that. I really hate white balance. I wish there was a way I could disable it so that it would just stop trying to fix things and just stop. I don't know what it is or why it exists or anything like that, but you know, on cameras it never bothered with white balance. I never had to deal with this, but now I do. It's annoying. Anyway, I don't know things about cameras. I do know that I never had to deal with this issue on older cameras. Okay, so I usually take a leaf-shaped brush like this. It's like a shape like that, like the tip of your fingers. And it's good for doing waves. And I push it in like that. Now, usually I start at the far side and work my way towards myself. It's a little bit tight. And it's awkward for me to work in here because the camera's in my way. I'm trying to make little puckers, right? And in the absence of little puckers, little crests like that, right? So you can do that either, like, get some on there. You see how there's little puckers on there? If I can get the reflection off there. That's little puckers there. Where you can do crests. And you do that by pushing the brush into them. And you can do that, and that's how you make like long, elongated waves. When it dries perfectly clear. And you can see, there, that's better. You can see how there's like rows and stuff. When it dries, but well, what the camera's showing is like white areas. Those dry clear, you can't see it anymore, but you can see the light reflecting off the little tiny raised areas that are actually waves, but they're not white anymore. The stuff goes on white, I'm guessing because of its nature, but it's also very helpful because it helps you know where you've applied some and you can see its shape better. Now, water likes to create little mimicked shapes of the surfaces that it comes in contact with. So you'll get wave around wave around wave around wave. Like, so there's like little waves circling outwards from objects that it comes in contact with. So you get concentric rings. But when the water's flowing like this, like on a, even on a gentle current, it sometimes cancels it out and you can't really see them that well. Unless they're fresh, like throwing a stone into a pond, then you get ripples, right? You know, rings. I was looking to see just how long I've been working on this project, and I believe it was March or February of 2020 is when I started this. And you know, you would think that when you work on a project as long as that, it would be really, really good, but I soon discovered that's not always the case. At least not for me. I've discovered that the longer I spend working on a project, the more mojo I lose for it over time. And I can't say that I really lost mojo for this project. Not a lot anyway. I got busy doing other things, and this project was very large, and it took up quite a bit of space while I was working on it. And I didn't really want to start a new project while it was on my bench because it took so much space up. And anytime I wanted to work on this, the new project I would start would have to get shelved or put away or whatever like that. The reason I know that is because I tried. I tried starting other projects, but it didn't work out. So I ended up just having this on the bench for way too long. And my interest in it suffered a bit because I didn't work on it as diligently or as with as much care as I should have or wanted to. There were times where I did, lots of times that I did, but it could have been better. This is far from my best work. There's all kinds of mistakes and things that I should have done better or spent more time working on, but I didn't, and I regret that now. It's way too late to do anything about it. But when I first started working on this project, you know, I had every intention of getting it done in just a few months, like I do everything else. But that's not what happened. I'm trying to make a little bit extra wavy underneath the bridge here. It's difficult because I can't really see what I'm doing all that well. A box underneath the thing here that should have more resin in it, but it didn't fill it. I just noticed it now. Just noticed that I don't have the autofocus turned off. Something I want to do. Autofocus is irritating. That constant shifting of focus while I'm trying to demonstrate something or show something to you guys is enraging. Well, to me. Be a lot easier to demonstrate to you if the surface of the water wasn't so reflective. I've got probably a good 45, 50 minutes of work time with this, at least with this stuff that I'm using now. The woodland scenic stuff I've actually never used before, so I'm not sure the work time on that. I don't imagine it's any different, or if it is, it's not a lot different. It's probably around the same. But I want to make some rings around this outspout, downspout. I want the water to be somewhat churned. I can use the same material I'm using now to add effect to that water there too, which I'll get to as soon as I'm done. One of the things you got to be careful of is not to get this stuff on your scenery like I just did on that barrel. It doesn't look right when you do it. I'll have water doing something that it normally doesn't do, and that's climb up on stuff. Just gonna get back here. Ooh. Trying to get it under the boat. Bridge is an awkward spot. It's hard to work under, but I've tried to do it so that I could, like I've, in previous works anyway, I tried to make it so I could remove the bridge and work underneath it. I discovered that's really difficult to do. Really difficult, and doesn't work very well. See what I'm doing, but that's okay because neither can I. Okay, I think I've got that. All right, so now what I usually do is I mix a bit of this coarse texture gel, which when it dries looks like that. It's like a foamy looking thing. So I mix that with a little bit of the clear stuff and it kind of softens it a bit. It's not so rough. But I don't always stick to that because sometimes I just add it by itself, because when I do that, it makes it look like fresh foam, like beach foam. Alright, so mix that up. That around the base. Use it to shape the downspout a bit. You gotta remember it's water, so it's actually, when it moves, it's quite smooth. All right, so what I have to do now is where it's around the water here, I have to wait for that to dry a bit, get firm, and then go back over with more texture gel, or the clear gel, so it becomes nice and shiny again. Otherwise it'll look like overly rough, like it looks too textured actually. That's what happens. At least that's what I always do anyway. And as soon as I clean off my brush here a bit, I'm gonna streak this. I'm lifting the brush so it makes little hats. There. The little hats, they make it look like the water's hit and then it's splashing up. So, and there's the phone. It wasn't for me. Right, so it's only been like 30 seconds since I pause the video there, and like I was just putting the last little bits on there, but you can see how it's already starting to dry here, where the white is starting to disappear. Eventually it'll all be gone, all that white will be gone except for right around here. All right, and then once that's gone, I'll come back with a little bit more of the coarse texture gel, and I might add a few more little bits of like foamy looking stuff, because this water is moving quite fast, and splash it about, and then add a little tiny bit of the clear over top of some of it to make it look nice and shiny, because water's very, very shiny. So and then that's really it, right? There's nothing else that I would do to that. So I guess that's about it. So I will come back once this is dried, and we'll see what it looks like, and I'll show, I guess, where I'm adding the foamy bits on there, and we'll see how it looks. In the meantime, I'm going to finish off the R35, and then probably start getting ready to do the final reveal. I don't know if I'm going to do it in this video or a separate video yet, but we'll see. Anyway, back in a bit. All right, so it's all dry now, except for a couple of little tiny itty bitty spots here and there that I'm not about to touch anyway. And I'm fairly happy with the way it looks. The only thing I want to do now is I want to build up a little bit more, activity around the downspout. So I'm going to add some more of the texture gel to the area to give it more, so it's, I guess, more frothy, lack of a better word. Hello, Murphy. My dog has joined me. I don't know if you guys have ever seen Murphy. I'll show you Murphy. That's Murphy. Say hi, bud. My camera came off its mount. Scared the shit out of me. Scared the shit out of the dog, too. But, oh well. So anyway, like I said, I'm adding some more froth to the scene to give it a bit more activity. Try to make these thinner. Not easy to do with this dorky brush, but it's the best brush that I have for this. See what my dog was doing, making a chewing noise. He's lying on his little bed behind me, chewing on his bottoms of his foot. We just came back from being outside and it's all slushy and gross. So it's cleaning the goo up from under his toes. That dries, it'll be completely clear in about maybe an hour or so, I guess. That's usually about how long it takes, about an hour. I don't think there's anything else that I wanted to do to that. So I think I'll come back in a second and I'll show you what it looks like when it's done, and then I'll do a final talk through on the video. And then do the final reveal, I guess, in a separate video. I think that's what I'm going to do. Yeah, that's what I'll do. All right, so that's basically dry now. I might consider adding some splashes. like rising water, like pluming out like that from either side of this. I don't know if you guys can see that. This thing here, that's what inspired me to do it. That's actually just a flower that's grown there, but it's not hard to add. I mean, it's basically building up more of the foam, and then once the foam is done or dry, you just hit it with the gloss meat, the texture gel, or the crystal gel, or realistic water, or clear silicone, whatever the hell you're using, and you just shape it, all right, like into a cone, and that's it. It's pretty simple to do, but I don't know if I'm going to do that right now, so that's why I've done it, because I'm undecided at this moment. If I do it, then you'll see it. Anyway, so I'm officially calling this thing finished. There's nothing else I'm going to do other than wait, because this little spot right here, that right there, still needs to dry. You can see it's got that milky kind of look to it, just because it's not quite dry yet. And there's still a couple of little itty bitty spots that are still just a tinge milky. It usually takes a full day for it to completely dry, and it's only been about maybe 5 hours, 6 hours, something like that, all told for this. So it's usually completely dry by the next day. So there's nothing else that I'm going to do to this other than put it on the shelf. I still have to figure out how I'm going to take photographs of this. It's somewhat difficult to imagine trying to take pictures of something like this. I don't really have a place inside my home to take pictures of something like this, which is why I usually take pictures of stuff like this outside. Now, this is not the time of year where that works right now, because it's winter. And actually today there's about maybe 10 or 12 centimeters of snow on the ground, and it's piss pouring rain, so I don't think I'm gonna get a whole lot of pictures done for a while. So what I'm probably gonna do is take pictures inside with a backdrop, just a plain backdrop, like a slide projector screen. I just roll it out and prop it up, and you know, so it has a curved background, and try and take pictures that way. And then when the weather is more conducive, take fresh pictures. I've done that before, just added to the album at a later date. So the slideshow pictures for this thing probably won't be very complimentary, but maybe in a while some better ones will appear on my Facebook page. I guess that's it. I guess for all intents and purposes, I'm calling this done. So I'm going to put together a slideshow, but it'll be a separate thing, and that'll be the next video, which immediately follows this one. Now that this is done, I can get it off my bench and start my next build, which is going to be my entry into the Warts and All Facebook groups, sci-fi group build, which runs from December 4th until May the 4th. December 4th of 2021 to May the 4th of 2022, if you haven't figured that out already. So I'm kind of jazzed about that, because I want to build something different and something, I don't know, simple. And sci-fi tends to be that, depending on what you do with it anyway. So my first entry, because I would like to enter more than one if I can, is going to be a scratch-built speeder for my 1/12 scale Bandai First Order Trooper to ride. The Trooper is actually probably going to get a paint job to make him look like he's been around a while, or someone's wearing his armor anyway, so it'll look a little bit weathered. That's my plan anyway. And so the speeder is going to be, you know, fairly big, and he's going to be sitting on it and stuff. So that's my first build. What I build after that, I have a number of things that I can do. So we'll have to see. I have to flip a coin because I want to build them all. What else? I think that's it. Yeah, so I guess I'll save the rest for the slideshow, which is the next video. Anyway, that's all I got. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.